Hey Jackals, today we'll make a simple mouth animation like the one you see now in DaVinci Resolve. Now let's get digital. Before I show you how to do the effect, let's take a look what we actually need. We need an image. I have two images here, both are PNGs and they have transparent background, so I'll put them in the media pool. And we need an audio file. The bottom one is music. And this top one is just something that I've recorded inside DaVinci Resolve in the free light page. If you want to know how to record in the free light page, I'll also link a video up above. So this will be an example audio file that I'll be working with. Hey Jackals, this is just a quick demo how you can make mouth animation. So as I said in this example, you can have multiple audio clips. So music, effects, someone else talking as well. And then you have the voiceover that you want to apply this effect to. So before we actually do anything, the audio file needs to be a WAV file. So I'll go to export. In the video, I'll uncheck export video. Then I'll go to audio, change the format to WAV, and it needs to be linear and 16 bits. What you can also do is export individual clips, but in my case, I'll just export a single clip. And the output track, in my case, I don't want both audio clips to be shown. So I'll use timeline track and I'll select audio one. And for good measure, I'll just put an endpoint with I and outpoint for O. Then I can give it a name and set the location and then simply export this. Okay, so now we have the WAV file. So we can go back to the edit page and put it on the timeline, just like that. And if I zoom in, you can see that it's basically the same. Right, so this was just the test so that you can see that the WAV file is actually the same, but you don't need to put it onto the timeline. You can have the previous file. Now, if you want to apply the mouth effect to the current clip that you're editing, I suggest to export the audio as I've shown. But once you do, just make sure that you put this back to how it was. And also make sure that you export the video and also change the output track back to bus. So you export all of the audios. Now what we'll want to do is to put an image onto the timeline. So in this case, I have two images. Let's just say I'll show you on this one because it's tilted a little bit, but the easier one would be this one because it's pretty much straight on. So I'll select this one and go into the fusion page and I'll just extend it to the end of the clip. And what's important is that the length of the image is the same as the clip that we'll be applying this to. So in my case, the exported WAV file has the same length as this clip. So that's why the image will be the same length. Now in the fusion page, we'll have to make a cutout for the mouth and to move those. Now, because in this case, my head is tilted, I'll have to first straighten it out. So I'll use a transfer node and just adjust the angle, maybe something like that, just go 15. But if you have an image like this one, you don't need to use this transfer node. So we'll just have a media in. So now what we want to do is to make a cutout of the shape. For that, we'll be using a polygon. You don't need to have the polygon shown. And I'll just make a quick selection. And we can adjust this later on. And also disable this button. Why you want the animation to be disabled? Well, let's say that you're somewhere in the middle when you make this polygon and it's enabled, then you go back to the beginning and you have everything done and you then start moving this around. So let's zoom in a little bit. You do it like that. You make a nicer looking selection. And then when you play this, the polygon starts animating and you don't want that. So that's why we just make a quick selection and we'll fix it later on. And the first thing that I want to do is to make just a cutout of the mouth. So I'll be adding a merge node. This will be now the foreground, this will be the mask, and as for the background, we'll just use a background. So now we have this image in the foreground, the background is in the background, and with the polygon, we mask out this shape from the background. So we have only the mouth visible. Now in the background, we'll simply adjust the alpha so we only see the mouth, and we'll be animating the mouth, and we'll be moving those up and down. So we'll add another transfer node and we'll be basically moving them up and down with the Y axis. So now we have the mouth that will be moving up and down, but we need to make a cutout from the face. So to do that, we'll add another merge node. This time, this will be the background, and the foreground will be a background with the same polygon. Now, if we display this one on the left, you can see that we have the cutout of the mouth. And then lastly, what we'll want to do is to merge these two back together, so we can connect them like that. But in this case, the mouth that will be moving has to be in front. So simply switch this with Ctrl T. And now if you go back into the transform and adjust the Y position, you can see that we'll have what we want. So now that you have what we want, let's make a better mouse shape. And then we'll just copy this over to the second polygon. I'm just holding Ctrl to move the handle separately. If I didn't hold Ctrl, both of the handles would move. So maybe something like that. I can now delete this polygon and copy this one over. Now we have the mouth shape done and it looks okay here. Well, I have to click away so that we can see. So it looks okay here, but we can see a line here. So to fix that, select the second polygon. So you get the second polygon's options, then click away to get rid of this line, so that you can actually see what you do. Now here, we'll just adjust the border, and we can go in a tiny bit, just like that, and the line is gone. So we have everything done. The only thing that we need to do is to connect this transform node, the Y position, to the sound file. And to do that, we'll actually need a plugin. The plugin is called Suckless Audio File Modifier, and it can also be found on Reactor. The installation is simple, so just follow the steps. But if you install Reactor and it doesn't open for you, go to Workspace, Scripts, Reactor, open Reactor, and inside here, once it opens, then simply type in audio at the top. As you can see, I have a few of them installed, and this is the one you want, Suckless Audio. Once you install it, you may need to restore DaVinci Resolve. So now that you have the audio plugin installed, you'll want to adjust the Y position in the transform node to animate it. To do that, you can use the custom tool that has a bunch of options, but you can use any tool that has a slider that goes from 0 to 1. So in this case, we could also use maybe the text node, and we could adjust the size. It goes from 0 to 1, and that's all you need. But in this case, I'll just use the custom tool. Now in this case, I'll just use the custom tool, and I'll use the number in 1, but if I don't want to see the other numbers, I can simply disable them here. And now we only have the number in 1, and that's the one that we'll be using. We can also rename this node from custom tool 1 to something else. Simply select it and press F2. I'll use audio anim for audio animation. And now what we want to do is to right click a number in 1, modify, and select audio WAV file. Now depending on what you have installed, this may be someplace else. For me, it's down here. When you click on it, a modifier shows up, and we'll adjust it in a second, just so you can see. And in the transform node, we'll want to now animate the center position. So right click on it, and click expression. Now because we only want to modify the Y position, we'll connect it to this node. So because I changed the node name, this now starts with audio anim, otherwise it would start with custom tool 1. Then we have dot number in 1. Now go back to the custom tool node, and as you can see, the modifier tab showed up. If you click on the modifier tab now, you can see that this is collapsed. So double click on it to open it up, and now we have to load the WAV file, and that's why we made the WAV file. So let's go to the file that we have, which is the test file. Now if you play this as is, you can see that the mouth is jumping up and down. So the first thing that we want to do, let's select the frequency. I'll choose the middle one. This is just a quick demo for you. It's jumping up and down too much, or the range is too big. So this final step may take a little bit of time, so fine-tune the settings. In my case, I had to use unsigned media. Infrared values, if this is not selected, then the mouth animation will move up, which is not what you want, as you can see. I've used range from 300 to 3000 Hz. I've scaled down the amplitude to 0.1 and the amplitude offset to 0.5. And what you want to achieve is to have the mouth at the beginning, where you don't talk anything, closed. So in this case, I've managed to adjust the animation using only the amplitude scale and offset, but if I didn't, I could go to the merge tree node, which is the last node, and I could adjust the Y position to make an additional offset. Now the last thing that I want in this case is to rotate the image back, so I can simply copy this transform node, connect it in the end, and put this to 15 degrees. So now this is basically the same as it was in the beginning. And now because I use the transform node, the mouth won't be moving like that, it will be moving like that. So I made a tiny adjustment at the end, because the mouth wasn't opening as much as I wanted to, I simply adjusted the amplitude scale. And in this case I've put 0.2 as opposed to 0.1. Hey Jackals, this is just a quick demo how you can make a mouth animation inside DaVinci Resolve in the middle of the clip, and you also have multiple audio files. Now in this case I have a solid colored background, and if I wanted to have the mouth shape to have the same background color, even if I change it so I don't have to change it inside, the way to do that would be to change this here. So this background here would have to be transparent, and let me just show you why. Because it's black currently, it would also have to be in the background, so Ctrl T to switch between the inputs, then make this transparent, and this polygon, the shape of the mouth, would have to be the mask, and you need to invert it. And now we have a mouth opening that's the same color as the background that you choose. And that's how you can make simple mouth animations. And if you want to see DaVinci Resolve and video editing content twice a week, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell notification icon so you know when the next video comes out. I'm Simon, and until next time Jackals, keep it digital!